Either or now for a wine that I have a particular weakness for, reds from Ribera del Duero in Spain. I would have to say if I had to pick a region of Spain that would be a go-to for me, or a region that I would be confident I'm going to get a really good bottle of wine out of every time I buy one, would be Ribera del Duero. Situated in around sort of the area of Valladolid, which is sort of north and west of Madrid, sort of to the west and south of Rioja. It's a relatively new deal in the grand scheme of things, where it was sort of set up at about the mid-1980s. Wine was produced there obviously a long time before that, producing super bottled wine a long time before that, but in terms of officialdom, I suppose, in terms of Spanish wine worlds, to 1986 is when it sort of kicked off as DO Ribera del Duero. So made 100% by the Tempranillo grape variety, which in the area there is called Tinta del Pai. The big thing that adds the sort of uniqueness and character to the wines of Ribera for me is the dineural temperature fluctuations. So you get a really cool night due to the altitudes, cool night, hot days, and it's obviously it's very internal in Spain as well, and summer's going to be very hot during the day. So hot days, cool nights, and that builds a really tough tannic skin, I suppose, or more robust skin, I suppose, in the grape variety, smaller berries, and you're going to get a lot more colour, extraction, intensity and flavour out of the actual finished wines. So this one here, Vina Mayor, is the Crianza. It's produced what's known as the Golden Mile of Ribera del Duero, where I suppose all the big houses are there. So Vega Sicilia, Pingus, and people like that. Vega Sicilia, in my experience, I've been fortunate enough to try it a few times, and it's right up there with the best wines in the world, and in a side-by-side tasting with, you know, top French and American, wherever in the world, it usually comes out on the top side of it, not top one or two wines in a tasting side by side. The wines from there are fantastic from that particular house. And you can see it across the wine region, you know, obviously in some wine regions where you've got a star name like Vega Sicilia, others may sort of hang on the coattails and sell on that sort of Ribera del Duero label as such, or, you know, Bordeaux label for Mouton, whatever the case may be. I tend to find Ribera del Duero that while Vega Sicilia is produced there, whatever you get in other wines is usually very good quality for what you pay. Now, they're never going to be the cheapest wines in the world, of course. You're going to pay a little bit more for them than, say, Riojan wines, but you always get a good package. So this particular wine is 12 months aged in French and American barrels. Fermented in stainless steel, first of all, to retain the fruit purity, I suppose. But color-wise, medium to full body, nice and bright ruby edge. Nice, sweeter black fruit profile. Some sort of like baking spice sort of nose to it. Sort of cinnamon, nutmeg, that thing. A little bit of licorice-y sort of notes. Nice. Good mouth feel. Quite grippy on the tannin side of things. You feel it around your gums, around your teeth. Quite creamy on the finish. I see oak influence coming through there as well. Just it comes through with like a nice blackberry, blueberry compote sort of flavours. I see you had like a bowl of blueberries, blackberries, with some sort of cream, sort of desserty type thing. Finish is nice and long. Beautiful bottle of wine. Another really solid wine out of Ribera del Duero. Great with red meats, spicy dishes it might work well with as well. That sort of oak flavour can go quite well with spicy notes. The chorizo flavours and things like that there should work quite well with. Lovely bottle of wine. Big fan of Ribera del Duero wines, I love them. If you haven't really tried them before, you don't know much about them, search them out, try Vinamayor, try many other ones, and if you've got the budget, try Vega Sicilia, the Valbuena. You know, it's about 120 or 30 quid a bottle nowadays, Valbuena, which is their second wine. If you're buying their Unico, it's a 350 quid a bottle. We have them on our website, check them out. You know, super treat. That's the one to buy for me. So there you go. Vinamayor from Ribera del Duero, one of my world's favorite wine regions. You'll not be disappointed. KWMWine.com, place for taste matters. Cheers.